Hi, this is Captain Tim Barefoot. Just wanted to show you how you could take some cigar minnows and squid, readily available right over here beside you next to these decoy jigs on the shelf. This is a 4-ounce crab, and there's also a 7 and 11 ounce squid, and turn them into these. This is just a frozen cigar minnow. They work just fine. Live ones probably work a little better, I think. And take the main jig hook, put it up through the underside, out the bridge of its nose or through its skull right there, that's the best place. And then take the stinger hook and put it through the belly there so it's nice and tucked in with the hook point exposed. You want the hook point exposed. Okay, so don't stick it in the bait and let it stay hidden. Put it in there so this is what you wind up with. A nice clean tackle, piece of 100 pound fluorocarbon tied in a loop knot here to the head of the jig. That's important, I think. If you don't feel comfortable tying that loop knot, crimp that connection. And I'll explain it on underwater film why you should do that, because it allows the bait to sit level. But down to a nice pretty cigar minnow like that, that's a recipe for grouper. You do that, I guarantee you bites. All right, this is the 11 ounce squid decoy. Just a heavier version of the squid, and your cigar minnow out of the box, a frozen one, on the circle hooks. Now you take this first circle hook, put it again up through the head, and then take the back circle hook and put it, figure out where it'll lie neatly on the bottom, just like that. Lay it out so that you measure it, and then go through right there so it doesn't put the minnow in a bind. Okay, and leave the hook tip again exposed. So that's what you wind up with. You wind up with a cigar minnow that looks like he's been caught by a squid. All right, let's take a frozen squid that is one of my all-time favorites. Fresh or frozen, they work great. Take the front circle hook on this decoy jig, push it through the front of the mantle up there like that, and then let the second circle hook lie down the body, kind of lay it out so that you know where you want it to fit, and just barely punch it through and let the hook point stay exposed like that so that you have two circle hooks back there. So that's what you have. A squid that looks like it caught another squid on the bottom out there. That is grouper fishing, not amberjack fishing. Okay, to rig this J-hook chin weight, simply go through the bottom out the bridge of the nose like this. Take your wire and go through a couple laps. Don't pull it real tight, just pull it up a little snug. Couple three like that. Take your spare wire, make a lap around. Cut off your spare wire. There you go. Nice clean tackle. Notice this cat's paw connection, how it's made. Nice clean fluorocarbon connection on a great swimming naked bait, gets bites. And the same thing with this snailed circle hook version. Same exact process you follow to do the J hook, you do with the circle hook. Snell it or cat's paw. Either one works great for either one of them. All right, we got your basic, barely legal Spanish mackerel, perfect for bait size. We're gonna take a wire and give us a punch through the eye sockets so we don't have to take his eyes out. You possibly might want to just go ahead and take his eyes out, but this is a nice fresh one. And this is the 11-aught chin weight, made for Spanish mackerel. Put it up underneath his chin. Barely out the bridge of his nose, just like that, to keep his mouth shut. Okay? Take your wire and go through that hole you just made. Pull one down. Go around. Back through. Pull that one just nice and snug, not real tight. Through again. Pull that down like that. Make a couple laps. Flip the rest off with your clippers. You got your stinger hook just right. That's out of 180. That's number 12 wire. There's your stinger hook, everything just right. Ready to swim. Nice cat's paw connection here on the front with 130 pound fluorocarbon. There we go, got him ready to swim.
CoastalAngler.com?
Yeah.